Hi everyone, this is Brendan here. Welcome to my next episode, day 37 of my Let's Clash series. So in this episode, it's quite an interesting episode because I found my goal so much that my goal overflowed by quite a bit. So I started the morning off by doing this attack. So as you can see, I found this base with 300 over 1000 gold available. And a lot of the gold are kind of inside the gold mine. So just focusing on the gold mines on the outside. Just deploying one archer and also like a bit of the minions on the outside to clear 4 of the gold mines. And going ahead to try to take out the elixir collectors too. Because my elixir is kind of low because I did an upgrade the day before. And now going ahead to take out the Barbarian King, which has just gone down from the attack of the minions and also the archers, and then now dropping my clan castle on the top, which will actually make their way into the base. So the wizards are going to be behind backing up the giant. The giant is just going to take a lot of the damage of the mortar and also the archer towers. So now as you can see, I've gotten 250,000 gold already. So some of the gold, a bit of them are inside the gold storages, so I wasn't able to get all of them. But not to worry, we're gonna go ahead with the next one. We've also 300 over gold, 1000 over gold available. So going ahead with this attack, the gold mines, they're all outside on the exposed again. So going ahead to take them all out with the minions just flying above the cannons. Cannons not gonna do any damage to them. And then just going ahead to deploy my troops more at the bottom, trying to take out that 2 DE drill over there. So the DE drill, they're just going to go down, not able to take out the left one. But not to worry, I stole a little bit of the dark elixir, which is pretty alright. So going ahead with the next attack of this 200 over 1000 gold. But it's not going to be a lot, but of course it's just going to be an easy raid because the gold mines, they're just kind of exposed on the outside. So just going ahead with it. And then once the gold mines have gone down, I was kind of deciding whether to go for the 1 star or just end the raid to surrender and then just sacrifice the trophies. So now as you can see, I just decided to sacrifice and just lose it. And then going ahead to find another 304,000 gold. I mean, today's loot is pretty insane. As you can see, I've been finding a lot of 300 over 1000 gold available bases. In fact, it was kind of crazy, such a way whereby my gold overflowed kind of early. I didn't expect my gold to increase this much in such a short period of time. In fact, I was farming so much that in like roughly 1 hour, I got like around 1.2 million gold and also like 800,000 elixir, which was kind of above my current average. I mean, you must take into consideration that I only have 5 barracks to use. At the same time, the level of my barbarians and archers ain't like a max level for my current town hall level, especially my archers, which are only level 4. So my minions are also only level 1, so the damage output from them ain't too high. But yeah, going ahead to do all these high loot rates are really alright. Especially when my clan castle have really strong troops and also having the Barbarian King with me, although he's only level 1. But he do take up and soak up a lot of the damage from those mortar and also the wizard towers. So he's just acting kind of like another extra giant over there, which in a way a higher damage giant, to be honest. So now as you can see, I just deployed my troops at the bottom, focusing on the gold mines in a V-shaped manner. And now I was just going to try to take out the tower, especially when the 2 mortar on the left and right, they're just gonna go down right now from the damage of my archers and also my wizards. So now the wizards on the left and the right, they're gonna take down the town hall. And going ahead to just end the battle with a 1 star, 46%. So going ahead to find this Town Hall 8 with 353,000 gold available, which is really awesome. I mean, I've been finding like crazy amount of loot. Now as you can see on the top right, I mean, this was just kind of in the morning only, and then my goal was already almost overflowing. Now as you can see, it's already halfway, not overflowing. As it's kind of abnormal, to be honest, in like in 1 hour to get like roughly 1 million to 1.2 million gold isn't a normal for my this current rate for my with this kind of army and also with this kind of troops that I'm actually using. Usually this kind of a rate usually occurs when I'm actually kind of a little bit of boost using the boost, but I didn't boost any of my barracks or whatsoever. But it was pretty alright to get this kind of amount. In fact, it was a pretty good, not pretty alright, especially when I'm farming in Gold League. Not going to go ahead and try my luck at Silver League and also in Bronze League, as some of you has mentioned to me, saying that the loot there is pretty crazy and finding like 800 over 1000 gold, this and that. But I just do not want to take the risk to go all the way down there to find those kind of bases, because I've already tested with my other accounts and I really don't think it's going to be really good for me to go there to farm. So I didn't want to take the chance to go ahead to go there. So now as you can see, we're going to do a defend on my base because I was kind of not free to actually play already, so I went to go for defense. So I decided to have some witches inside my clan council. Two witches and one archer. So you're just gonna see as how good the witches are using them for defense. So now, as you can see, the witches, they just keep spawning the skeletons, and skeletons just keep coming out. And in fact, now even the level 2 Barbarian King wouldn't be able to do any damage to my witches, and he has just got taken down without any defenses targeting him, to be honest. Just a damage from the skeletons and also from the witches. So level 2 witches, they spawn the skeletons really quickly, and also so many in such a way whereby they just unable to take out the skeletons as quick, especially also the archers. Now, as you can see, they ain't gonna take out the witches until the guy decided to deploy the archers kind of behind or near towards my witch, and then the witches got taken down. But as you can see, there's so many tombstone over there with the Barbarian King getting taken down, and then now he's only left with like 15 level 4 giants and 18 level 4 archers. So let's see what's he gonna do and how is he gonna get the resources. I mean, there's like 600,000 resources for him to steal, but then I don't think he's able to get all of it, because it's just not too easy to go ahead to get all of it. So as now you can see, my this base, the elixir is kind of exposed, so I might tweak it a bit once I reach the town hall 9, because I need the elixir to upgrade my walls. It's either I have to tweak it in such a way whereby I'm able to defend the elixir storages better, or I have to use my elixir or go in such a way whereby I go, whenever I go offline, the amount of resources ain't a lot for people to steal. But that's not always the case, as what you just saw, there's like 300 over 1000 gold and elixir respectively for that guy to actually steal from me, because I wasn't free to actually continue to clash and stay online. So going ahead to do my very own attack, going ahead to attack this base with focusing my troops on the top side, where my troops just keep pouring in, and now they're gonna go ahead to take down the town hall. Town hall is gonna go down pretty soon. So now, as you can see, the town hall has just got taken down with the help of the wizards. Of course, the wizards are dealing a lot of damage. So this base isn't too difficult to attack, especially we're not using any wall breakers, but I still managed to break my way into the base. So I'm still considering to whether to use my level 3 wall breakers or not, because to be honest, they ain't too strong in my opinion. I'm trying to get them to level 4 before I actually use them. So I'm trying to get my Barbarians and Archers to the next few levels before I actually do upgrade my wall breakers. But not to worry, I'll still be doing my minions first. Minions, I'll try to get them to level 3 or level 4 so that I could use a BAM in a more efficient manner, rather than using just level 1 minions, which ain't really too bad but ain't really too good too, especially when the damage from them ain't too high. And of course, one thing to note, which is the Dark Elixir usage, as the cost from them, one level 1 minion doesn't cost as much as like a level 6 minion. So using level 1 minion, I mean, if you just need one minion to take out one cannon, using a level 1 minion, to be honest, is more cost efficient, because they still get the job done, which is they still get the cannon taken out. But then of course, the amount of time required for the level 1 minion to take down that cannon will take a slightly longer time. So now, as you can see, this base is tower 8 with 400 over 1000 gold available. Gonna go ahead to attack it from the top and the bottom, because there were two gold mines on the top and the bottom too. And the left and the right, there were also one gold mine each. So I was gonna try to focus on the right side first. Now swinging back to the left side, gonna take down that gold mine, which I actually prepared my clan castle. My clan castle is gonna go down. But I was kind of surprised when my clan castle didn't come out the wizards. I mean, I thought my clanmates would actually give me the wizards. So they gave me a P.E.K.K.A, but I mean, we will see how is this P.E.K.K.A is gonna fare against trying to take down that gold mine, because I'd rather have a wizard and also some giants inside my clan castle. The reason is because they will be able to shoot over the wall, but now in this case, I still have the P.E.K.K.A trying to fend off the archer towers and so also the cannons from my archers. So going ahead, the P.E.K.K.A is just going to take one more swipe, taking out that elixir collector, and unable to take one hit on that Barbarian King. Otherwise, I'm pretty sure the Barbarian King might be left with like 20% health, or maybe in fact a one hit KO on him. So going ahead with the next attack of this 275,000 gold available base. Not going to be too difficult, because the gold, they are just on the outside. So a lot of you might be thinking why and how am I finding this kind of bases. I mean, it takes a while to find. It's not like every time, like every 3 to 5 minutes I'm finding this kind of bases. It takes like maybe roughly around 5 to 10 minutes, whereas this kind of base will occur usually once. So in 10 minutes I find this base, so in roughly an hour I find 6 of these bases, which I should be able to get like around 1 million gold in an hour. Taking into consideration that I still need to spend gold to search for the bases. So going ahead now, as you can see, my Dark Elixir storage has completed its upgrade, getting it to level 2. My capacity has increased to 20,000. So I have another 10 more thousand Dark Elixir to actually farm. I'm going to upgrade my Dark Elixir storage to the next level to get it to 40,000 capacity, so that I could get my Archer Queen when I reach to level 9, which actually requires 40,000 Dark Elixir. So Town Hall 9, once I've gotten it, I should be able to get my Archer Queen immediately. Hopefully, maybe not immediately, but maybe in the next 1 or 2 days, as it will take quite a bit of time to actually get 40,000 Dark Elixir. But not to worry, we will focus a little bit more on Dark Elixir once we reach the Town Hall 9. So going ahead to get a little bit more of the gold, because I upgraded my wars, 9 of my wars from level 7 to level 8. So I'm left with 500,000 gold. So as usual, using my same strategy, removing an obstacle, now going ahead to steal a little bit of the gold. And then once I've stolen a little bit of the gold, once I've gotten 50,000 gold, I'm going to go ahead to go back to my base. And then I'm going to upgrade one more war, getting it to the next level, level 8. So spending that 500,000, left with 51,000 gold. And then of course, I'm just going to use a little bit more of the gold to upgrade the walls, and not trying to have a lot of the gold for people to steal, so that when I go offline, people won't find that I'm a juicy target to attack. And they might even just take my Town Hall and just end the battle, maybe even just stealing a bit of or maybe all of my elixir. But it's not a problem for me, because the elixir ain't really problematic. Although now my elixir has gone down like 1.8 million and left with like 1.2 million elixir, but it's not really a problem. So now, as you can see, my wars, they have increased another 10 more, getting them to 140 right now. 140 level 8 wars. So my plan for my free builder, which is I will wait for my Dark Elixir barrack to upgrade to level 2, which will take another 1 day and 17 hours. So after that Dark Elixir barrack has gotten to level 2, I'll be having that free builder free up. And of course, to be able to upgrade my wars at a quicker pace, as that will be during the weekend, and I'll have more time to actually farm the gold to upgrade my wars to level 8, hopefully getting majority or 80% of them to level 8 wars before I reach to Town Hall 9. And now checking out my profile with 592 attack wands ready. And of course, my donation is very poor as usual. And then, but not to worry, I'll be getting my archers to level 5 soon in the next few days, hopefully in the next few episodes. So I just want to give you guys a small little sneak peek, which is I'll be heading back to SG Gladiators next Monday, once the season actually resets, so that I could actually go back there to manage the clan a little bit. And of course, as mentioned, I'm only spending 2 weeks in this clan. So yeah, I'll be going back to SG Gladiators to farm over there for you guys to actually see. So with that said, I'd like to thank you guys for watching my video, and clash on.